worship you, Son of God. You are so good, Almighty God. Hallowed be your name. Your dominion is forevermore. Adonai, Adonai. We worship you, Son of God. You are so good, Almighty God. Hallowed be your name. Your dominion is forevermore. Adonai, Adonai. Son of God, you are so good, Almighty God, hallowed be your name. Your dominion is forevermore. I say Adonai, we worship you. You are so good, Almighty God. Hallowed be your name. Your dominion is forevermore. Adonai, Adonai. We worship you. Yes, Son of God. You are so good, Almighty God. Mashekaya, hallowed be your name. Your dominion is forevermore. I say, Adonai, we worship you, Son of God. Son of God, and you are so good, Almighty God, hallowed be your name. Your dominion is forever. Yes, O God, Adonai. Adonai, we worship you, we worship you, Son of God. You are so good, hallelujah, Almighty God. Hallowed be your name. Your dominion is forever. I thank you, my Jere. Hallowed be you. Hey, Jehovah Shammah. You are so good. Oh, my King God. Hallowed be your name.
Hey, Oh, You alone, Lord, you, oh, for debt, looking for loan, because there's an emergency occurrence. Father, we bless your holy name. Accept our thanks. 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 In the name of Jesus, our Lord and our God, we appreciate you. We appreciate you. We appreciate you. Jehovah, we give you praise. Jehovah, we give you glory. Jehovah, we give you adoration. There is none like you. Be thou exalted, O Lord. 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 Be thou magnified, O Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
They were doing a sampling of those that died in UK last week. And they saw that the blacks are the ones that died more than any other ethnic group. Beloved, thank God that you are not among. Thank God that I am not among. Thank God that your children are not among. Beloved, you may sing, we may dance today. There are some people, they are already mourning. Oh, Father, let's begin to appreciate Jesus. Father, we thank you. We are not mocking those that went, but we just want to appreciate you for our health. Thank you for our children. Thank you for our ministry. Thank you for our life. Thank you for what you are doing. You are mighty in our sight. You are great in our sight. We give you all the glory. Father, we appreciate you. The ancient of this, the mighty man in battle, the I am that I am, the author, the finisher, the beginning and the end. Father, we bless you. Father, we bless you. Father, we bless you. Father, we bless you. There is none that can be compared to you. Ancient of this, our God, you are good. You have been good to us. You remain good to us. Accept our thanks. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Bible, the Bible says, beloved, Bible says, if we say we have not sinned, we say we are liars, and we need to go to God presently and ask God. The Bible said there is no truth within us when we say we have no sins. I want us to tell God, wherever I've sinned unto God, I know my own, you know your own. Let's tell God, let the voice of forgiveness begin to speak for me. The forgiveness begin to speak. Father, in the name of Jesus, where I've sinned unto you, my Lord and my God, let the voice of forgiveness from above, let me hear it in the name of Jesus. I come to you, God, with my baggages of sin. Father, forgive me. 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 Lord, I am human. That is where I've come. David said, I was conceived in iniquity, and iniquity my mother gave back to me. Father, I am praying, Lord, everywhere I've sinned unto you, Father, forgive me. Wipe away my shame. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let's cry to God and say, God, I need your mercy. Let your mercy speak for me. Beloved, begin to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, my Lord and my God, I need your mercy. Let your mercy speak for me. I need your anointing. Let your anointing speak for me. Father, I need your favor. Let your favor come to me. In the name of Jesus, begin to pray. Tell God, I need your favor. I need your favor. I need your favor, oh God. In the name of Jesus, let favor locate me. Let favor locate me. Let favor locate me. Let favor locate me. In the name of Jesus, Father, we thank you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let's tell God, Lord, let's today's service be an unusual service, filled with anointing, filled with healing, filled with the power of God, filled with the palpable evidence of God's glory. Let's begin to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come into this service unto you. Father, fill the service with your anointing. In the name of Jesus, fill this service with your power. Fill this service with your unction. Fill this service. Fill it with your presence. Let today's service, let us see your glory in it. In the name of Jesus, let us feel your anointing in it. In the name of Jesus, Father, touch us. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Beloved, I want us to raise our hand up to heaven and say, Father, touch me, oh God. Let me feel your touch. Begin to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I have come today. Father, touch me. 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 I need your touch. I need your touch. Holy Spirit, touch me, oh God. In the name of Jesus, touch me, oh God. In the name of Jesus, touch me, oh God. In Jesus' name, we pray. Beloved, topic I want us to pray this morning, the topic God has given us to speak, is Father, let your hand be evident in my life for good. Amen. Begin to pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, let your hand, let it be evident in my life for good. Let your hand, let it be evident in my life for good. In the name of Jesus, let your hands, let it be evident in my hand for good. In the name of Jesus, I need your touch. I need your touch. Holy Ghost, 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 I need your touch. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. In the name of Jesus, I need your touch. I need your touch. In the name of Jesus, I need your anointing. In the name of Jesus, I need your touch. In the name of Jesus, I need you to touch me. Father, touch me. Father, touch me. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
The book of Isaiah 41, 13 to 14 says, for I, the Lord your God, hold your right hand. It is I who said to you, fear not, I am the one who help you. I want us to turn it to prayer. Oh, say, Father, in the name of Jesus, hold my hand right, hold me by my right hand. In the name of Jesus, Father, hold me. Father, hold me by my right hand. Father, hold me by my right hand. In the name of Jesus, Father, uphold me. Father, uphold me. Father, uphold me. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. My God, I'm there. Masekaya Baba. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, 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 yes. Father, uphold me. In the name of Jesus. Father, uphold me. In the name of Jesus. Father, uphold me. By my hand. In the name of Jesus. Father, uphold me. In the name of Jesus. My Lord and my God. Uphold me by my hand. Yes, yes, yes. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Beloved, when the hand of God is upon us, it brings us to a great place. I want you to cry. I need God's hand. It is God's hand that takes people to the place of fulfillment in life. Hallelujah. When God's hand is upon you, you will see mighty things begin to happen. Say, Father, I need your hand upon my life. I need your hand upon my ministry. I need your hand upon my ministry. In the name of Jesus. Beloved, cry for God's hand. God touch me. Cry for God's hand. Father, I need you. 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 Yes, yes, yes. Mashakayawa. Father, touch me. It is God's hand that takes one to the place of fulfillment. It is God's hand that takes one to the place of blessing. Father, begin to say, Father, I need your hand. Father, I need your hand. Father, I need your touch. Father, I need your hand. Father, I need your touch. Oh, Lord, touch me. Oh, Lord, touch me. Oh, Lord, touch me. I need your touch. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Hear what the Bible says in that Isaiah 41. He said, fear not. I am the one who help you. Oh, that means it is not that man that gave you a favor. It is not that man that help you. Talking of that man, he will not help you. It is not that woman that help you. Hey, beloved. It is not your brother that help you. It is not your sister that help you. That promotion, it is not your boss. God is saying, I am the one who helped you. Oh, I want you to pray to God. God, don't stop helping me. Oh, you're being alive today. It's not because of your health. It's not because I know how to do it. Oh, I'm using medication. No, 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 no. I'm doing exercises. I am eating good food. No, no, no. God is saying to Joker, to Isaiah. He said, it is myself who helped you. I am the one who helped you. Isaiah 41, 13 to 14. I am the one who helped you. Mashiach, God is telling Jacob. Jacob, do not fear. Yes, yes, yes. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. If you look at that scene, he said, fear not. You warm Jacob. Can you imagine? God is looking at Jacob. Look at him. You are like a worm, and you and worm has no bone. Have you seen it? Look at another Bible for me. Isaiah 41, 13. I like another version. He says what? He said, I am the Lord. Isaiah 13 to 14. Look at verse 14. Say, fear not, you worm Jacob. What is called a worm? Something that is not able to defend itself. Say, God, you know where I am vulnerable. Help me, oh God. Oh, many of us are vulnerable. Where we cannot pray, we cannot fast. Yes, yes, inclusive me, including me. Lord, know where I am weak. I need your help. That is why the Bible says, you warm Jacob. You warm Ephraim. I know I am the one that help you. I am the one that pronounce your blessing upon your life. I want us to pray, say, Father, let your blessing be evidence upon my life. Let your blessing be evidence upon my life. In the name of Jesus. He said, fear not. I am the one who helped you. I am the one who upheld you. Fear not. I am the one who made my favor to pass before you. Fear not. I am your God. In the name of Jesus. Yes, 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 yes. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Amen.
Say, fear not, you warm Jacob. All you men of Israel, I will help you, says the Lord. Can you turn that to prayer? Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, you have promised to help me. I hold on to your promise. Isaiah 41 verse 14 tells me that God, you will help me. Lord, I look up to you, my Redeemer, my Savior. Help me, oh God. Help me, oh God. Help me, oh God. Help me, oh God. Your word says you will, irrespective of my behavior, you will help me. My Lord and my God, help me, help me, help me. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. He went further. He says, says the Lord, and your Redeemer, and your Holy One of Israel. He says, verse 15, say, behold, it will make me, Ephraim Patugashe, I don't know about you, it will make me, Ephraim Patugashe, into a new sledging edge with sharp teeth. That means God will make me productive.
Amen.
Beloved, I want to understand this. When you go and cut a tree and you are holding a dull axe, you are wasting time. Oh, what Bible says, he said, it will make me into a new threshing, threshing sledge. Not only a hammer. A sledge is bigger than a hammer. Into a new sledging sledge that has a sharp teeth. Said, we shall thresh the mountains and beat them small. That means he will enable me. Oh, beloved, pray. Say, Father, your word says you will strengthen me. Your word says you will enable me. Your word says you will back me up. I hold on to this. In the name of Jesus. Mashakaya. Can you understand it? He said, you use me to thresh mountains and beat them small and make the hills like sharp. Oh, say, he will uphold me. That is what I'm looking up to. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Yes. Yes. In the name of Jesus. He said, you will uphold me. Yes. You will uphold me. Yes, yes. Yes, yes. Yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. In the name of Jesus. You will uphold me. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Beloved, I'm going to another 10-point prayer point. What have I said? 10 what? 10 points, prayer point. Open your Bible with me into Isaiah 45. There is a man there. We are talking to our message today. Is God, let your hand be evidence upon my life.
Amen.
Before we go to the message, let's do some prayer exercise. Oh, Isaiah 45 from verse 1. Isaiah 45 from verse 1. What does it say? Say, thus says the Lord to his anointed. To who? To Ephraim. That is not Cyrus. Put your name there. To Ephraim, what the formulate for to Gashe? To the whose right hand I have upheld. I want you to change that prayer. Say, Father, as you oppress Cyrus, as you upheld Cyrus, uphold me in the name of Jesus. Oh, it entered the word of God. That God says, to my anointing, I upheld him. As you uphold Cyrus, Father, uphold me. Uphold my children. Uphold my ministry. Uphold me, oh God. Uphold me, oh God. Uphold me, oh God. Uphold me, oh God. As you upheld Cyrus, you are anointed. Father, uphold me. Lord, uphold me. In the name of Jesus, uphold me. My Lord and my God, uphold me. My Lord and my God, uphold me. My Lord and my God, uphold me. Uphold my wife. uphold my children, uphold my ministry. In the name of Jesus, as you appear, Cyrus, Holy Spirit, keep me standing. Keep me standing. Keep this ministry standing. May we not fall. In the name of Jesus, Father, uphold me. Keep me standing. Keep me standing. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Number two, he says to Ephraim, Fatugashe, say he will subdue nations before him. What did the Bible say? Have you seen it? When Ahasuerus put God I have obtained, why did they uphold him? Because God is saying, I want to subdue nations before him. I want you to turn to prayer. Say, every nation before me, you are subdued. Every nation before me, you are subdued. Every nation before me, you are subdued. In the name of Jesus, you are subdued. Every nation before me, you are subdued. In the name of Jesus, you are subdued. Every nation, you are subdued. In the name of Jesus, every nation, you are subdued. In the name of Jesus, the Bible says that ought to subdue nations before Cyrus. Who is the Cyrus of today? Ephraim Fatugashe, I am the Cyrus of today. God says he's upholding me to subdue nations before me. To subdue nations before me. Hey, who are down mountain before Zerubbabel? Who are down mountain before Ephraim Fatugashe? You shall be made low. Yes, yes. The word of God says he has turned me into a sledgehammer to break mountains, to make hills like sharp. In the name of Jesus, he has turned me into a sledging hammer to break every mountain. The word of God says, he will subdue nations before me. In Jesus' name we pray. Number three, he says what? I lose the armor of kings. What is that saying to you? What does armor mean? Armor means what somebody used to defend himself in the time of battle. And the Bible, God, what God is saying, he wants to use me to go to the king and begin to lose that defense, that it will make every king to be vulnerable to me. I want us to cry passionately to God that your word says you will use me to break powerful people, to break powerful people down. In the name of Jesus, every mighty people that the word says I speak, every giant, negative giant, he says you will use me to lose the armor of kings. In the name of Jesus, Father, use me to lose the armor of kings. In Jesus' name we pray. Number four says, to Ephraim Fatugashe, to open before him double doors. Are you there with me? He's opening before me what? Double doors. That means any door you knock, what comes? You see double answers. Hear me. God is saying that when you ask for one, I will bless you too. Say it's opening before you and me. Double doors. Beloved. Hear me. Let me explain to you well. When there's a single door and you're picking a large property in, and that single door cannot come in, what do? You open the other door and it becomes wide. God is telling me, your blessings is no more limited. I have a wide blessing. Beloved, begin to pray. God has opened unto me double doors. I begin to walk into it. Double doors have been opened unto me. Open unto my children. Open unto my ministry. I walk into double doors of blessing. Double doors of favor. When people are getting one, I am getting two. I am getting double. It means when people are sitting, I will be standing. When my mates are standing, I will be outstanding. When my mates are outstanding, I will be outshining. That means double door. In the name of Jesus. Double door. Say double doors. God is opening for me. In the name of Jesus. Number five. He says, so that the gates will no more be shut. Are you here with me? Beloved, I want us to pray. From now on, no gate, no good gates will be shut on me. Beloved, you are not praying this morning. Say, from now on, no good gates. That is what the word of God says. Number five. Number five means grace. Is that means I will grace you that no good gates, no good gates will shut on you. The word of God says he will grace me so that no good gates will be shut on me. No good favor will be shut on me. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Beloved, pray this prayer very well. Pray this prayer very well. Something happened last 2 weeks. One of my good friends died in Nigeria. And it's been long with something that's about 28 years ago. But 28 or 27. But when we heard that we died, we all went to school. We was a senior, but we were so close. When we heard that he died, we were so touched. You can go on YouTube. His name is on YouTube. We are so touched. His name is Pastor Wale Ogabi. When they had to do his prayer yesterday, they televised his prayer for the whole world to see. When his pastor was talking about him, he said, "Can you imagine? He gives somebody an appointment for the next day. He gives somebody an appointment for the next day. But the owner of life came and took the life." I want us to pray. Maybe that person, and I pray that I will bless you. That uncle, I need money for school. So come and see me tomorrow. But the tomorrow, the one never saw. That means God is telling you, he's telling me and you, that no gates will be shut on you again. Many people have got promises that when they got to that place, gates were shut. Many people have been waiting to marry for long. The month they chose marriage, many they have stopped all marriages now. Nobody can go and marry. Many people died, especially that they, people, my children will carry me. No one is going to bury them. Many people, we know many people that booked parties with my wife. That we want to do party, my wife will help them in the catering. They have to cancel the catering. Hallelujah. Hear me very well. Man plans, but God disposes. God is saying that, look at the person that has waited and waited and waited for the fruit of the womb. And the time that he married, that is when this problem occurred. You know what I mean? Then that he wants to marry, that is when the gates are shut. I want us to pray, beloved, that no gate will be shut on me. 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 Many people had planned. They had bought clothes. They had bought this. They had bought that. But they cannot use it. But gates are shut on them. The Bible is saying, no gates will be shut on you. Beloved, pray. He said, so that gates will not be shut. Gates will not be shut. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. 5B says, I will go before you. Oh, what does that one mean? That he will go ahead of you. Before you see you go to anywhere, God has gone ahead of you. Oh, do you know that brother? He's it, he's that. But when God goes ahead of you, he organizes favor for you. He organizes ways for you. He organizes times of pleasure for you. Where they have thought negatively, by the time you enter there, everybody begins to speak of your favor. Hear me very well. It's God that has gone ahead of you. He says to Cyrus, see, I will go before him. Oh, hear me, beloved. The same angel that came to the Israelite, he became a light for somebody, for the Israelite, and he became a what? Darkness for the Egyptian. The same God's hand of blessing can be favorable to some people, and the hand of blessing can be destructive to some people. I want us to pray that your word says you will go before me. Let your hand go, let your favor go before me. Let your hand be upon me. Let that hand of blessing, pray. Let that hand of blessing, let it touch me. Let that hand of favor locate me. Well, what says you will go before me? Anywhere I go, you are ahead of me. Before I speak, you are speaking. Before I say anything, you are doing it. Your word says you will shine ahead of me. So I will be shining in you. In the name of Jesus, I will be shining in you. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Beloved, look what I saw just now. As we are praying, look at this light up here. When this light is on, let me turn it on. You see that you cannot feel the evidence at all. It cannot feel the difference much. Because a bigger light has shined. Our God is saying, I will be your bigger light. So I will shine. Hear me? If there is no bigger light there, this light will appreciate it. Because it will shine into darkness. But God says, yes, you are shining. But I will be your bigger light. That means in you, in God, we will dwell. And as people see us, they are no more seeing us. They are seeing God. Because God has gone before us. Begin to appreciate Jesus for that. Appreciate Jesus for that. We are not finished yet. We got one more to go. And what did he say? The sixth one. He says, I will make crooked places straight. Hey, what do you need again? What is crooked places? Where you have prayed so much, but you cannot pass. Where you have labored so much, but there is nowhere. Every powerful thing that has blocked us, God is saying, I will make all those crooked places straight. From now on, He will make crooked places straight. Begin to pray. Begin to pray. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, your word says you will make crooked places straight. You will make crooked places straight. Father, I hold on to this word that no more will I suffer. But crooked places you will make straight for me. In the name of Jesus, you will make crooked places straight for me. In the name of Jesus, I hold on to your word. I hold on to your word. I hold on to your word. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Number 7. He says, I will break in pieces. People are the one. Are you seeing it? They are reading for Isaiah 45. Isaiah 45. We are on verse 3. Number, we are breaking the prayer points there. Number 7. He says, I will break in pieces gates of bronze. Mm. Beloved, bronze is stronger than iron. Mm. I remember one time when the mechanics, hallelujah, mm. I remember one time when I was my mechanics, I decided to stay. I was staying with them. Can we meet our phones? I can hear some things going on the what's it called? On the Zoom. Please, people on the Zoom, mute your phone. You are distracting us here. Hallelujah. Mute your phone. All the things you are doing at home, I'm hearing in my head. Hallelujah. Mm. Now, can I say to you that in those days, there are some welding that they will not be able to do the iron because they want it to last. So they have to use a bronze, not a copper. They use a bronze to do it. Bronze is thicker than iron. Mm. I want us to pray. God is saying that even those stubborn doors, are you getting it? Yeah. Those stubborn doors, God says, I will break them open for you. Amen. What is that stubborn door you have been knocking? Begin to walk into it. Begin to walk into it. What are the stubborn prayer points? Beloved, we can only get blessing when we believe, when we have faith. Begin to say, every stubborn door, I walk into you. Yes, yes, yes. You will no more be an hindrance to me. Stubborn doors, you will no more be an hindrance to me. Stubborn doors, you will no more be an hindrance to me. For God has made you open. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. The Bible says, number 8, say, and they will cut bars of iron. It will cut them in pieces. You don't need any other thing again. For bars and iron will cut in pieces for us. Number 9 says, I will give you the treasures of darkness. Beloved, whatever is valuable is not seen outside. Every good thing is seen under the ground. Every good thing is seen under the ground. For example, if somebody tells you that your backyard, they have planted gold there, what will you do? What will you do? You will do it and they not tell you where the gold is. I'm telling the people on Zoom, please mute your phone. People on Zoom, please mute your phone. I'm using a earpiece, it's distraction so much. Amen. And don't just leave your phone, attend by your phone, please. Hallelujah. You have, they told you, there is somebody, say the person that lived here before has buried gold in that my backyard. But we don't know the exact place he buried it. What do you think we will do, Brother Shola?
I will move to the backyard and start.
But we don't know. What do you do?
We'll be digging
everywhere. That is it. Because God said He will give us the treasures of darkness. Darkness is located under the floor. Say you will no more dig. He will bring those things out for you. Somebody say, I receive. And finally, he says, the hidden riches of secret places shall be brought for you.
Amen.
The hidden riches of secret places shall be brought for you. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Have you been blessed?
Yes.
Have you been blessed?
Yes. Sir.
I don't know why we are so tired of prayer. We've not prayed 5 hours. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That when we were young, we would go to VG, they would take all the chairs away. Mm. You will be standing. You cannot complain.
Yes.
Because our life must be good.
Amen.
So people are not at home, you are blessed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I say you are blessed in the name of
Amen.
Jesus.
Amen.
Put your hands together and celebrate Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let's sing our hymn to the Lord. And we go from there. Amen.
Amen.
Are you blessed?
Amen.
Let's take our hymn to the Lord. The hymn for today is, I am thine, O Lord. I have heard thy voice. Hallelujah. I am thine, O Lord. I have heard thy voice. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Say, I am thine, O Lord.
I am thine, O Lord.
I have heard thy voice.
I have heard thy voice.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's quickly open it. I am thine, O Lord. I have heard thy voice. Amen. Amen. I am thine, O Lord. I have heard thy voice. And it is good I love to be. Lord, have your way in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Lord, speak your word.
Speak your word.
Let your name be lifted up.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, my Father, my God.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jehovah.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, God of all things.
Thank you, Jesus.
We bless your holy name.
Hallelujah.
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 Have your way in the name of Jesus. Have your way in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Father.
In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
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 In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's be settled down. I had to go, sorry, I have to go and meet everybody on Zoom because maybe they didn't know their voices. What we're doing at home is distracting us here. But I've muted them so we can proceed in the word of God. Father, we commit this word unto you. Speak your word.
Amen.
As you prepared.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
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 Beloved, God is about doing a new thing.
Amen.
And say, God is about doing a new thing.
God is about doing a new thing.
Our message today is, oh Lord, let your hands be evidenced in my life for good.
Amen.
Oh Lord, let your hands be evidenced in my life for good. Beloved, the apostles were mere men. Say mere men.
Mere men.
They were ordinary men. Men minus Christ is crisis. The apostles were men that could not do greater things when the Holy Spirit had not partnered with them. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
But when the Holy Spirit partnered with them, they became extraordinary men. Say extraordinary men.
Extraordinary men.
Man minus God is ordinary. God minus man is still God.
Mm.
For man to be extraordinary and do extraordinary things in life, he needs the impulse of man in his proceedings. A woman came to Shiloh one time and she taught us a song. And I know this song, many of us may know it. A very powerful song. It's very short, but it makes more meaning. Man is nothing without God's hand. Even our earthly fathers, our earthly parents, when a child offends his parents, and those parents, they put a curse upon that child to make it in life for that child, he will struggle. So also spiritual parents. Somebody that has voiced blessings and God answers. But hear me, no curse in our life will stand.
Amen.
But when God's hand is upon man, things begin to change for the better.
Amen.
I see God moving somebody's life today.
Amen.
I see God declaring somebody favor today.
Amen.
I see God moving in somebody's ministry today.
Amen.
If you look at Genesis, let's quickly go to Genesis before we go to where we are going today. Let's quickly go to Genesis. Now I'm talking about when God's hand is missing in man's life. Man struggles. Look at Genesis 48. When Jacob decided to bless his children. Genesis 48 from 1. Say, now it came to pass these things, that means after many things that has happened, it came to pass that Joseph was told, indeed, your father is sick. And he took with him two sons. No, go to 49. I'm going. Let me keep us waiting. Go to 49. 48 is when he blessed Joseph. 49 is where I really want to go. 49, chapter 49. He said, and Jacob called his sons. 48, Joseph was very blessed. He blessed Joseph and his two sons. Remember Manasseh and Ephraim, wherever he crossed his hand. That's where we are going. That is, I'm talking about the blessed. Look at that one. In 48, you will see the value of the blessings of father. Despite the fact that Jacob was old, despite the fact that he was impaired of eyes, when Joseph was so wise, he knew that he was a junior that took the glory of the seniors, that went ahead of the seniors. So when he wanted to place his children, he had really timed it. He placed the first one where the right, the senior, or where the right hand of Jacob was, and he placed the junior, Ephraim, where the right hand, where the left hand of Jacob was. But when Jacob wanted to release blessing, the blind man, how did he know? Because in him, there is something that is beyond, that is extraordinary. When they got there, Jacob crossed his hand. Joseph said, no, that is important. He said, daddy, no, this is supposed to have the blessing. This one is the junior. Say, I know. Still, he crossed the hand and blessed them. But in 49, when my God's hand is missing in man's life, man struggles. Say, man struggles.
Man struggles.
49, and Jacob calls his son from verse 1. Say, gather together, that I may tell you what shall befall you in the last days. What does he say? He is prophesying to them in the last days, where you are still living. Your parents have the ability to change the course of God, the purpose of somebody's life. What are anybody you call parents? Be careful. They have the ability to alter. That is why children don't bring the curse of your parents over your head. They can alter the destinies. Of recent, that, oh my God, I'm digressing. Of recent, I just want us to understand. I had Bishop Duncan. You know Bishop Duncan in Ghana. He ministered something of recent. And he said, one day he offended his father in the Lord, Bishop Idahosa. And you know, Bishop Idahosa can be tough. And he told Duncan, I remove my hand in your life. Mm-hmm. And Duncan said, what does he mean? You are a human being. Duncan said, from that, go and Google it on YouTube. Go and Google Father's Blessing by Bishop Duncan. I says, when Bishop Idahosa said so, he said he don't care. Say, in those times, he was the only Pentecostal pastor in Ghana doing greater things. He said, all the other men said, no come. See, the moment that man of God said, I remove my hand in your hand, in your life, he said, everything began to turn around. And he said that the old Ghana government, they come to him for prayer. He said, from that time, they turned against him. And one day, in that time, they came to arrest him. When they came to arrest him, the people that came to arrest him, they told him, they said, sir, we have been given this thing to come and arrest you for long. The government of this land, they said, we should arrest you for long. But something kept stopping us. But what kept on stopping us, we did not know. Beloved, parental blessings can change your life for good. And parental causes can break somebody's life. And that anybody you call parents, maybe your physical or biological, maybe your spirit, whatever. So be careful. Don't let familiarity cut us from getting forward. So I said, go and Google it. He said, and he says, they've asked us to come and pick you for long, but something kept stopping us. He said he became a person of ridicule. So he said, and God opened his eyes. Because the man of God that you are walking under his covers, remove his hand. I am not exaggerating. I did not plan this before God and man. When I heard it, I said, wow. So he said, well, so along the line, he came to London. As he came to London, in that time, He said he just saw Bishop Idahosa at the airport. He said he prostrated, held his legs. And without the holiday, there's a place for his son. It doesn't matter, a father will never be hungry to the extent you see your son or your child, your daughter, and be annoyed. He said he held him. And only one word Bishop said. He said, Bishop, he said, and he said, Daddy, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I said, it's all right. It's all right. And what did Bishop Bidawasa said? He said, Satan, this is between father and son. Hands off. Before God and man. He said, that was only what he said. He said, Satan, this case is between father and son. Hands off. Hey! He said, that was all. He said he went back to Ghana, but he didn't be better. He got back to Ghana. They told him they come to pick him the next day. As he wanted to sleep, God said, don't sleep. As he prayed, he lie down. He said, God told him, when they come tomorrow, tell them you're not going. The one that could not say was not going before. When they came tomorrow, they told him, they said, we have come to pick you. He said, he told them I'm not coming. And they could not do anything. He said, okay, we are coming. They went outside. The man said, he's not coming. And they said, let us go back. They went back, they came back, said, Oga, meet us tomorrow in the police station. He said, I'll meet you. By the time they got to the police station the next day, we don't have any reason why we have arrested him. We don't have any reason to have arrested him. Hear me? When God's blessing is upon your life, you do favors. If man can do like that, talk less of God. Hear me? Jacob cursed Reuben. Gather yourself to me. Genesis 49. I may tell you what shall befall you in your last days. Gather yourself and hear, you sons of Jacob. I will put that, if I say that, I'll put it on the wall for us to see. You sons of Jacob, and listen to Israel, your father. Reuben, you are my firstborn, my might, and the beginning of my strength. Can you imagine? The excellency of dignity and the excellency of power. But verse 4, what did he say? Say, unstable as water. You shall not exceed because you went into your father's bed. Then you defied it and you went up to my couch. That means what Reuben had done many years, the father still held it but did not say anything. He waited for when nobody can change that course, that he was going to die. After blessing and cursing, the Bible says he died. So nobody had the power. And Reuben, not only Reuben, look at verse 5, Simon and Levi. You are brothers, but you are instrument of cruelty and in your dwelling place. Say, let not my soul enter your counsel. Let not my honor be united. But hear me, it doesn't matter the curse of any man upon your life. Be it your spiritual father, be it your physical father, be it anybody. When God's hand is upon you, God's hand remove the curse.
Amen.
Deuteronomy 33 verse 6. It takes a prophet to open the way. It takes a prophet to close away. It takes a prophet to break down. And it takes another prophet to erase. Deuteronomy 33, verse number 6. Look at me from Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus to Deuteronomy. What happened? Reuben has suffered. Suffered. But when he got to Deuteronomy, not one, not two, 33, from verse number 6. What did Moses declare there? A prophet can declare. Another prophet with the unction of God can repair. Deuteronomy 33 verse 6. What did Moses say?
Let
Reuben live and not die. And not his land, and let not his men be few. Whatever cause that has pronounced on that anybody, I break it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
No father, no spiritual father, no physical father, nobody can place a curse upon you.
Amen.
But please don't walk in the place of curse.
Amen.
Ask Reuben, from Genesis to Deuteronomy, he suffered. Hey! So, when... Look at what man's hand can do. Look at what God's hand can do. I said the apostles were ordinary men. But when God's hand partners with them, they became supernatural men. Say supernatural men.
Supernatural.
Turn with me to the book of Acts. We are going to read some few verses before we leave today. Say, God's hand come upon me.
God's hand come upon me.
I see that many times when we minister, we don't get time to pray. That is why I normally pray now before we minister. Hallelujah. Does it make sense to us?
Yes, sir.
Acts 1 verse 3. Acts 1 verse 3. Hear what Acts 1 verse 3 says. It says, hallelujah, to whom he also presented himself alive after his sufferings by what? By infallible proofs. Being seen by them during 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Amen. Somebody, and one of our teachers taught us. Hallelujah. About the person that wrote that place. Amen. Okay, let's leave that. It was Luke that was talking. Amen.
Amen.
He said, if only I form my account and make those Theophilus of all that Jesus began to do and to teach. Do you remember, Brother Shola, the teaching that you taught us about it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, whereby Luke said, Luke refers to the visible appearance of Jesus after Jesus' resurrection. To whom he also presented himself alive. So when God's hand began to work in the apostles, things they could not do before, but they began to do it. The apostles were the ones that could not make something, they could not even understand Jesus' parables. That when people have gone, they will come to meet Jesus, Baba. That thing that you said, can you bring it down? But when the Bible says, and people saw Peter, and said, and they knew that he had been with Jesus, something had impacted them. Say, God's hand has impacted them.
God's hand has impacted
them. May God's hand impact you and me.
Amen.
He said, and they knew. Say, how can Peter, a fisherman? Fishermen are illiterates. They were not alert. And they saw him quoting the Bible, speaking. They said, no. Something has tabernacled with him. Something has touched him. Hear me. Luke was able to see Jesus because he was no more Luke in the ordinary. He had become Luke in the supernatural. Acts 1 verse 9. Acts 1 verse 9. Now when he had spoken these things, while they watched, he was taken up. And a cloud received him out of their sight. Hear me, it takes the grace of God to see the vision of Jesus' ascension. Hear me, there are some things people you will see that people beside you will not see. There are some places you will go that you hear the voice of God. And you say, did you speak to me? So I didn't speak to you. You will know it was God that was speaking. Because you have aligned yourself in a place that God's hand can be with you. Say, God's hand come over my life.
God's hand come over my life.
It is God's hands that bring a man from the natural to the supernatural. It is God's hand that makes things easy. When you pray for somebody, but that person sees results, it's because it's God's hands in your work. It is God's hand that make you do business and make gain. It is not your power. Are you getting it?
Yes, sir.
Many miracles were performed by the apostles. Look at Acts 2 verse 43. Acts 2 verse 43. Talks about when God's hand is with man. 43 says, then fear came upon every soul. And many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. Had they do those signs and wonders before they met Jesus? No, but because Jesus had met them, he had impacted them, he has led them to wait, they have been endued by the Spirit of God, they began to do wonders. Say, Father, visit me with your Holy Spirit.
Father, visit me with your Holy Spirit.
We need that visit, that visit, that meeting. Amen.
Amen.
Acts 3, 7 to 11. Acts 3, 7 to 11. The Peter that was an ordinary fisherman, that his eyes could not see where fishes were hiding. When he came to Acts 3, 7 to 11, what happened there? The Bible says, and he took him. Then Peter said, look up from 6. Peter said to him, see what of gold I do not have, but what I have I'll give unto you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk. Verse 7, he said, he took him by his hand and lifted him up. There's some prayer you don't wait. Come over, my dear. Come here, my parasola. There's some, come, my dear. There's some prayers you don't wait. You are praying for somebody, that person is not getting up. The Bible says, and he took him, sit down, my dear, and he took him and jacked him and walk. That is, you need to get to that level. Some people may be waiting for those prayers to come. Are you getting it? You need to get to the level that, yeah, you don't have to wait. That was what happened. Peter said, hear me, in verse 6, he said, I do not have gold. Verse 7, he said, he took him by the right hand. And you what? Lifted him up. You jacked him up. Don't turn my prayer to ordinary prayer. That is where you must be aggressive. Look at Peter jacking him up. The man will say, no. Can you imagine these days, someone that is late, you are jacking him up. They say you want to break his what? His spinal cord. He did not care. At this time, your miracle must manifest. Say, your miracle must manifest.
Your miracle must manifest.
That is why a good pastor will not wait for people to sleep on that, to do mistakes on that. It will fight tooth and nail. You will, because my future, when you guys make it, that's when I make it. Are you getting my point?
Yes, sir.
It is a shame that say your pastor is working and he's doing something that is not right. So when God blesses you, you remember the house of God. Mm-hmm. He took him by the hand. You are no more sitting down here. He jacked him up. Things changed in his life. He said, Peter, walk. Lifted him, as he lifted him up, let us finish it. He took him by the right hand and lifted him up. And what happened? Immediately, what happened? His feet and ankle bones received strength. When he prayed, he did not receive strength. But when he moved the hand, what? The hand of faith, jack him up. Instantly, the feet and the ankle bones received strength. At times, prayer will not move. We need some actions. Hello? We need to back your prayer with some actions. Some actions may look stupid. Are you getting it? It may look stupid. But hear me, the foolishness of God the wiseness of God is greater than to help me around.
The foolishness of God is
greater than the wiseness of man. When you say God is foolish, it's better than the wiseness of man. God can never be foolish. He might say some things. You don't understand it.
Mm.
But that is God. Amen.
Amen.
That is Peter. Amen. Look at Acts 4:31. I'm talking about when God's hand begin to work with us. Acts 4:31. He says, and they prayed. And the place they were assembled were shaken. And they were all filled with the what?
With the Holy Spirit.
Shaken, earthquake. The prayer was propelled an earthquake. We have not prayed to the extent that people are shaking. The house is shaking. Baba Deboy said something. Have you had the testimony?
Yes, sir.
He said, yeah, when I come with some sort of it, you can hear testimonies. He said, when the Baba Luda Yami or Akida Yami was alive, say Baba does not speak English. But one day, Baba let us go to America. He said the hotel they lodged. But Baba prayed all night. Baba prayed there. He said till today they locked the room. Hear me very well. Till today, they locked the room of the hotel. They locked the old hotel.
After 20 something years, they opened
it. They opened it.
When he visited the
place. Can you hear that? Say they locked the whole hotel because people we yeah, fire like that, so tired. We have not got into that. There's some people who lock in the hotel, they'll be hearing voices in the room. They open the room, there's nobody there. Power plus power. They hear vibration, vibration, vibration. We have not prayed for people to see vibration. You see, we are here. We have been, when we come to prayer, we are no friends. See, we are no friends.
We are not friends.
It's when we make it that become friends. We will make it by force.
Amen.
Hey, you will not do this in vain.
Amen.
You will not do this. Please endure the insults now, so that our life can be better.
Mm.
Anyone in the Bible that wants to get greater things, they first go with Jesus. Back when Jesus said somebody, I cannot give the food of the child to a dog. Mm. Call a woman a dog.
Mm.
Me too, I will fight. I don't say, hey, thank you. You think I will go? Me, there's something you have that I need. Hey, thank you, sir. Even the one that dropped on the table, a dog can eat. I just say, I've never seen this thing before. The woman changed the course of her life. But when we stay, want to shift insults away. Acts 5:5-10, remember that? Ananias and Sapphira. Only the word, it did not cost them. It did not cost them. They said, why do you slay against the Holy Spirit? 5:10. He said, what did he say there? Let me take from 3. But Peter said, Ananias, why has Satan filled your heart to lie to the Holy Spirit and keep back part of the parts of the land for yourself? While it remained, was it not your own? And after it was so, was it not your own control? Why have you conceived this thing in your heart? You have not lied to men, but to God. Then, and that it did not cause him to die. And Ananias had this. His heart, hypertension came B. He said, how did he know? I was doing some study. This one is not for this day. Let us give you a snippet of the study. Let me give you a snippet of the study. I was doing some study of recent. And Pastor Shimolowo said last week that there's some book that they are not canonized, that they did not put in the Bible. And such books, I've got them here. We got Tobit. We got Tobit. It's not in the Bible. We got Judith. It's not in the Bible because they are not canonized. But some Bibles, some Anglican Bibles, they have all those names. Do you understand what I'm saying? So, and he was talking about it, and I began to think, wow. So they call it there's some deuterocanonical books. They call them the apocrypha. They are not included in the Bible, like Tobit, like Judith, like Esther Greek, Wisdom of Solomon, Baruch, Letter of Jeremiah, Azariah, Susanna, Ben and Greg, Maccabees, Esdras, a lot of things. And so there are some books. Do you know one book that was not in the Bible? You can go and Google it. Go and Google. Let me give you the name. Just go and Google. You see it on Wikipedia even. There are some things that Jesus did.